This is gonna be a lot harder than I thought it would be.
I'm so cold. I'm cold. I am cold.
Hey, I'm Vivian.
Hi, I'm Carolina, and today we're gonna be changing our routines to see if we are more productive. We are trying routines from highly successful people like Oprah Winfrey, Barack Obama,
Elon Musk, Arianna Huffington. We're gonna try all these habits and hopefully learn something that we can take to our own lives. When you work at home or you're a freelancer or you don't have like a set schedule or structure like I do, it can be hard to either stop working and like actually take breaks or to be productive.
My unproductive habits is sometimes I get distracted and I go on TikTok.
Our first task is to go to bed without an alarm to wake us up and to get 8 hours of sleep. I'm gonna struggle with that one. I just like don't get enough sleep ever.
So this is something that Arianna Huffington does. I believe she actually wrote a book about it called The Sleep Revolution, how we shouldn't be depriving ourselves of sleep, which to me I find very important because anyone who knows me knows if I don't sleep, I am probably the crankiest bitch on the planet. Oprah Winfrey has also spoken up about this, and she's also said that she doesn't really use alarm clocks. To me, it's kind of scary because I really need alarm clocks to fall asleep or else I don't wake up. I just sleep all the time. So we'll see you guys tomorrow morning.
Time to go to sleep.
Getting up without my alarm is definitely like more calming, but I wanted to wake up earlier than this. I didn't want to sleep in as much as I did.
My problem that I had sleeping last night was I was so anxious about not having an alarm that I would wake up just to like look at my phone, be like, is it good? Are we alive? Can I go back to sleep? So I feel very tired because I just kept waking up.
Without an alarm, I didn't hit 8 hours. 6 hours and 13 minutes of sleep. I'm actually surprised because my body generally wakes up without an alarm around the same time. I think my body's just used to it. So it was cool that it let me sleep in. I just wish I'd got enough sleep to begin with.
Okay, so we're about to try some aquamarine type stuff right now.
In the morning, Jack, who's one of the co-founders of Twitter, he drinks this like salt juice concoction. It doesn't sound appealing to me, but he's also a multimillionaire, so what do I know? People try to add salt to their water because we need more electrolytes because we are not absorbing our water as much as we should be.
Bottoms up. Honestly, I think it's because I squeezed so much lemon juice in there that I don't really taste the salt water. So absorb up salt.
It doesn't taste good. I think this just takes a lot of commitment to make this like a daily habit, but it's working for Jack. Maybe it can work for Viv.
So this next task is done by Mr. Barack Obama. So he said back in 2012 that he would only ever wear like a matching blue suit or a matching gray suit because he has already so many decisions he has to make that the last thing he wants to take hours on deciding on is what to wear. I never think about my clothes. I always just pull from the bottom of my section. So if, like, I'm wearing a t-shirt, I go to my t-shirt area, grab the last one. I go to my jeans, I grab the last one, and there, that's the fit. I can't even think about it. So today, I will not be wearing a formal suit, but I will be wearing all blue. So I have my blue sweatpants, and then I have a blue top.
Even if I'm just looking at tops, my plain black tops are like still a moment. So I think this is my version of like a blue professional suit. This is the thing that's making me feel like, you know, a bit of my style is infused and like this is actually like a fit and not just like clothes. Now we're here and I'm bored of this whole look.
Okay, so the next part of this day, this is something done by Bill Gates and Elon Musk, where they time out their day in like 5 minute increments, which stresses me out. It's said to help them because it helps visualize their tasks. I kind of already do that, like I make a to-do list, but I've never like cut stuff down.
Even just writing the 5 minute increments is taking a lot of time. All it's showing me so far is that I spend a lot of time working out and I'm spending a lot of time in the car. I'm already someone who overthinks and overplans, so this kind of feels like a little bit too much for me.
Okay, so I made my slight to-do list. I have to start on one of them because it's 9 o'clock already. So I'm gonna start and then I will kind of finish this list as I go on today, but here's my to-do list. Let's get started.
Jack Dorsey, who's one of the co-founders of Twitter and Square, this man is a billionaire. He uses an infrared light. I've heard of these before, And apparently they're supposed to be good for anti-aging and healing wounds. Honestly, I'm not super worried about anti-aging right now, and I don't have any wounds at the moment, so maybe if this is effective and I start doing it now, I'll age like J-Lo.
Oh, it's hot. I guess because it's infrared. I feel like I'm like a lizard in like a science classroom with an infrared light. We're just knocking things off my list. I'm going through it really quickly, and I think it's because I like to swipe things off, if you will. I'm also way ahead of schedule.
Not gonna lie, it actually feels like I'm laying on the beach and the sun is like kissing my face. I thought this was gonna be kind of annoying because it's like super warm, but it actually feels really calming. Granted, I don't know if I could get work done while having this lamp on because it honestly is kind of putting me to sleep. It's so calming, I think this would be great for taking a nap.
Updating you guys with this infrared light that I got going on. It makes me very sleepy. Very, very sleepy. And I've been doing this for about 2 hours now, so. Now this next task is taking a video call outside while walking.
I believe it's Austin Russell who runs 5 to 10 miles a day.
Which could not be me, I don't even know how to use my feet. But basically it's just to help with fatigue. Yes, we'll see how if this really helps with my fatigue because that infrared light is really making me so sleepy. So I'm excited to be out with some real light.
Walking and doing this was not going to work for me outside with two phones. So I am FaceTiming my mom here while walking on the treadmill instead.
Wow, I really don't feel tired at all anymore. I wasn't distracted at a meeting. It's usually when I am on meetings on my computer, I'm like grabbing my phone or I'm like scrolling through Amazon. Don't tell my managers. But here outside, like I really do feel so refreshed. And it looked like, honestly, my coworkers even were like, wow, like I should jump on this meeting and walk outside. And they did. So I feel very much influencer. And honestly, I think this might be something that I take into my everyday routine. I can see why the successful people do this now. So the next task I will be doing is doing an ice bath sauna situation. That's supposed to help me calm down and wind down after the evening. I have the ice bath all figured out, but it's the sauna back here that I'm gonna have trouble building.
There's so many pieces to this thing. Oh my gosh.
Oh my god, this is gonna be a lot harder than I thought it would be. My cat's doing a great job of helping me.
This was more work than I expected, but we're done. What Jack Dorsey does is he'll do 15 minutes in the sauna and then he'll jump out and do 3 minutes in the ice bath. I don't know what that's gonna feel like. I feel like it's gonna jolt me, which I don't know why you would do that in the evening if you're trying to like calm down or like chill out, but what do I know?
Basically for the sauna, what you're trying to do is you are releasing toxins by sweating it out, and then your endorphins get a bit of a rush when you jump into the ice.
I don't think this was made for someone of my stature. So the 15 minutes is up and I am drenched. I'm literally, oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, let's jump into go to the ice bath.
I'm not even being over dramatic. It is so cold and I have to add this ice. I'm f***ing cold. I'm so cold. I'm f***ing cold. I am f***ing cold. Woo! I can't lay back. I can't. I'm so cold. Woo!
I can't do this. Oh my god. Oh my god.
I'm really trying to understand how this is relaxing. I is tired. I don't know how these rich, successful people have all this time to do all these things while also doing their work. I know they have whole teams and stuff. I don't know. I feel like the walks were really a game changer for me. I would love to incorporate that into my life. The personal sauna was great. I felt so relaxed. The ice baths, y'all can miss me on the ice baths. I don't need that. I don't need to do that again.
This was such an interesting experience because I did things today that I never thought I would ever do. I used an infrared light. Didn't make me sleepy 1000%. I went on a walk today. I found out there was a school in my neighborhood. That goes to show that I don't exit my apartment. I'm definitely gonna do the walks in a meetings every time I do them. It was sick. It was awesome. I felt really like rejuvenated after. So I'm definitely gonna be continuously doing that.